Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Don't Fear the Spreadsheet podcast, episode number 8, Insert Row into Existing Data. Hey, welcome back to the Don't Fear the Spreadsheet podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from MrExcel.com. We have Tyler Nash with today's question.
So I already have like a ton of data, but I need to be able to insert a whole new row. Is there a way that I can insert either a row or a column into existing data?
All right, Tyler. Hey, yeah. Okay, now you said you have a ton of data. I just made up this little data set here, so I don't have a ton of data, but the concept is the same. Let's say that we want to add a new south region, and it has to go between east and central. So here's what we want to do. If we want to insert a new row after east, we actually have to go to the row that we want to insert the row before. All right, so right there, I choose. That was weird. What was up with that? Okay, I choose row 3, and I'm going to right-click and say insert, and that's going to insert a row above like that. If for some reason I would need to insert a new quarter between quarter 1 and quarter 2, it works kind of the same. You go to, it's always going to insert the row to the left, or the column to the left. So I go to column C, I insert, and I get a new column to the left. And everything else is shifted over. All right, now this works great provided you don't have anything else out here to the right side of your data. I'm going to move on to the next worksheet. Now here we have two data sets on the same worksheet. Well, not two data sets, but we have two very important things. We have the sales report, and then over here I jotted the list of groceries I have to get on the way home, and I don't want to insert a row over here. I want to keep this nice and compact and contiguous. Contiguous, there's a word for you. All right, so in this case, we are going to select all of these cells here. All right, so before I just had, I selected the whole row. Now I want to select specifically the cells that I want to push down. And I use Alt-IE. Let me try and make the screen smaller here so you can see the right-hand side. Right here on the Home tab under Insert, there's something called Insert Cells. Alt-IE is the old shortcut for that. You could also use Control Shift Equals, and we're going to shift cells down. Now watch what happens when I do this. That takes the old cells and it moves everything below it down, but it doesn't affect the data outside here, outside of the selection. All right, so that's a cool way to go. We could also do the same thing here, although that's going to cause problems. But let me just show you Alt-IE, shift cells right. Click OK. All right, now that screwed up my grocery list over here, so I'm going to Control Z to undo. I realized that was going to happen before I did it. And another way, and I'm going to thank an old coworker of mine named Pat. Pat showed me this cool trick. If we have the new data that has to go in there, so here's the data for South, and I need to insert it in the middle, I can actually come down here and I'm going to Control X to cut. You could also use the cut icon up there, and then select where I want it to go. I want it to go between east and central, and under insert. Now, because I have cut, the menu actually changes. I can insert cut cells, and it just put all of the south and shifted everything else down. So there's yet another way to go. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. Check out Don't Fear the Spreadsheet. This book makes Excel for dummies look like it was written for rocket scientists.